I am Pat Clark with Lifting Gear Hire Corporation, and today we're discussing our hydraulic gantry system. We're going to offer a basic demonstration as well as some safety guidelines. It must be noted, however, this is not meant to be a substitute for being properly trained or for thoroughly reviewing and understanding the use and care manual. Every time one of our hydraulic gantries is being utilized, we send out an operational manual with it. It's highly recommended that all personnel working with and around the project be properly trained, regardless of prior experience. In addition to that, the manufacturer of these gantries highly recommends a lift plan be in place before any operation begins. We want to start with the basics. You want to work with a surface that is smooth, level, and engineered to withstand the forces of the gantry itself. The manufacturer recommends using runway track like you see here. Consider this the foundation of the entire system. You want to run the track perfectly parallel and square to one another. In addition to that, you want to assure that the track is completely level and plumb. You can do so by adding shims throughout the system. If your lift plan calls for the use of cribbing, it's still recommended to crib underneath the runway track. The unit is designed and engineered to carry the forces only on the wheels, no other part of the gantry. Next, you're ready to set the gantry legs within the track. Make sure the track itself is free and clear of any dirt or debris to ensure a clear path for which to move. Once your legs are properly set, you're ready to install the header beam. After removing the top portion of the top plates, set the header beam on the bottom portion so that the beam is cantilevered out past the top plate several inches. This is for beam deflection purposes. Once the beam is precisely set, replace the top portion of the top plates and properly secure them with the supplied bolts. There are lots of different valves located throughout the motor and the unit itself. It's very important to never adjust them without written permission from the manufacturer. Also, you should understand the relationship between the pressure gauge along with the load chart that's affixed on the unit and in the use and care manual. One of the more important factors to consider are the electrical requirements for these units. Each one of these legs requires 115 volts and at full load can draw up to 20 amps. It's critical to make sure that you're operating on separate circuits, otherwise you will trip a breaker. I've already considered the proper length and gauge extension cord to power these units. As far as the power pendant is concerned, we ship it separately, but of course along with the unit. The connecting points have a male-female end. You'll find the counterpart, secure it in, screw it down, make sure it's nice and tight, and now you're ready to test the unit. Before attaching any rigging to the header beam, we want to make sure that we thoroughly cycle the system a few times. We want to make sure that those vertical posts are going up nice and plumb. We also want to check for any unusual oil leaks. Light leakage in the system is normal, heavy flow is not. Also inside the use and care manual is a pre-lift checklist. Make sure you thoroughly review that. It's recommended to extend the header beam beyond the header plates. Even well-designed and well-executed lifts sometimes have some factors that weren't considered. Under deflection, we want to ensure that this beam doesn't get separated from the header plates. Along the lines of deflection, there may be areas along the beam that are too minimal to detect. We'll consider a severely off-center gravity load that's overloading one of the legs of the gantry. A good way to monitor that is to look at and constantly review the pressure gauge of the gantry leg itself. However, because of off-center gravity loads, it's not uncommon for the gantry legs to work at different speeds. This is because of the proportional relationship between pressure and load. However, these forces can be monitored by using a simple level underneath the header beam. In fact, the manufacturer recommends only having a half an inch variance over every 20 foot of header beam. We should repeat the process with the vertical post as well and check for plumb. If it's out of plumb, you could cause damage to the equipment or worse, an accident. That's why, as mentioned earlier, the pendant offers features such as simultaneous and being able to operate each jack independently. If your unit comes with the optional integral drive as shown in this photo, it will allow you to move the unit back and forth, but not up and down at the same time. To switch to the function that allows you to lift up and down, there's a valve located on the top. Also, there's a ratchet that allows you to lower or lift the adjustable wheel in the front. Thank you for watching this demonstration video. We hope that you found it helpful. In our rental fleet, we offer a 20-ton capacity, with beams ranging from 10 foot all the way up to 22 foot in length. For more questions regarding our hydraulic gantries and other products we rent, give us a call. As a reminder, the contents of this video were for informational purposes only. Please consult the manufacturer's guidelines and use and care instructions before beginning.